to lead this team because he had all the right tools, which starts with his basketball skills, but also his locker room skills, his, you know, the way he's befriended and led his team is something unique.
Yeah, that true leader. Mm-hmm. And then just the people they've added in the last year, it's just been fun to watch the people that have stepped up, the rookie, Kristen Brown in these last few games. I mean, I think the whole city and state, if you haven't closely followed it, and we often talk about the fact we couldn't watch a lot of the games, you got to meet all of them in these playoffs.
Well, we're going to be out here watching the scene evolve. We're going to be hearing from the players, these champion Denver Nuggets, the coach, Michael Malone, who himself had plenty of doubters. So stick around. We have all that for you coming up from out here at Ball Arena in just a little bit. But let's get back to Kyle and Alex. And I imagine the studio is pretty excited.
Yeah, I would say so. It was just a surreal kind of very wild, out of control game for much of
the newsroom was quiet a lot of the times. We're like, you know, can we breathe on this play? Because it just kept going back and forth. I mean, the lead would go from team to team. You would have a run for, you know, a good 7 or 8 points, and the next team would. I mean, it was just, you didn't know how this game was going to come out.
This was not a dominant performance. There was more than one time I looked at my calendar again to say, okay, game six would be when, game seven would be when, because, I mean, they were down 8 at the half. They were down as many as 10. Things were not looking good for the Nuggets. I mean, at halftime, they were 1 for 15 from three-point range. They couldn't hit their free throws. They couldn't hit from distance. Bam Adebayo for the Heat had a great first half. He was playing great. The Joker, kind of a quiet night, although he ends up with 28 points and 16 rebounds. He can do it all. And then the crazy thing is at the end, KCP wins this thing with a steal. I mean, you hold a team to 89 points in the NBA championship. Miami wasn't shooting so great either, but Denver got her done when they needed to most. And what's really kind of special about what we're seeing right now is that the Nuggets are celebrating the first ever NBA championship, 47 years of basketball without one of those titles, and they're doing it here at home. We haven't had a celebration here at home since 2001, since the Avs did it. The Broncos have won 3 Super Bowls. Obviously, Super Bowls are on the road. The Avs won last year in Tampa. They won their first one in Florida. So it's been a long, long time since there's been a championship celebrated here in Denver. Now I'm glad they lost game number 2, because it's so much cooler winning it in 5 here at home.
I mean, it's the biggest in Denver sports moment since the Rockies play-in game in 07. When they played it. In terms of just like a let's watch this town explode with emotion, and hopefully nothing else, explode with emotion tonight, because we've got such a big sports moment at home. You got to go back to 2007 and that Rockies play-in game. And I mean, that was absolutely wild that night. So Nikola Jokic, after the game, 2-time MVP, wins his first championship. They ask him how he's feeling, and he says, quote, "The job is done. We can go home now." That's how they have approached this, that they knew that they had the talent to compete for an NBA championship. And all along the way, you watched as this team was restrained, because they knew that this was the goal and nothing less. And now I think Nikola Jokic just wants to go home to his horses in those little carts that he rides around in. But you know what? If that's how he wants to spend his time, God bless him.
Yes.
He's a champion.
He can do whatever he wants.
He can do whatever he wants.
Funny, because you talk about kind of keeping it low-keyed. They were a lot like a hockey team that didn't want to touch any trophy until they could touch the Stanley Cup. These guys did not celebrate. They're up 3-1. Michael Malone constantly saying, we haven't won a damn thing yet. He kept telling his team that. He kept telling the media that. He kept them even keel. He kept them low even after big wins. And now they've accomplished something. They can go out and celebrate.
Yeah, we're proud of this team. It's all about Nuggets Nation. Who is among Nuggets Nation tonight? Kim and Tom outside of Ball Arena.
Yeah. Well, and it's the arena is going to start emptying pretty quickly here. We're going to see a lot of people coming out here and wanting to be part of this celebration, with those who weren't among the lucky 18,000, 19,000 got to see it firsthand.
I know. But, you know, I saw so many, and you see the crowds that come downtown to watch it. It's, you know, you want to be in that moment and remember where you were, who you were with. You hope you're with the people that you love or your best friends, and then you can all go back to that and say, I remember when we were together. You know, I remember how old I was. And and where I was and when I watched this game and this championship.
And I really think when you look at one of the reasons why this Nugget team was able to win this championship was very much what Kyle just said, Nikola Jokic was saying afterwards. We got the job done. They never took their eyes off the prize. They always knew what they were playing for. Well, they have been at the DNVR Sports Bar since before noon today. Kelly Ranky's over there, and I imagine it is pandemonium.
Guys, I think I've lost my hearing. I have lost my voice. Let me take you into this party. They are taking this all in. I have seen grown men cry on the floor. I have seen so many tears. I may have beer in my hair from it flying everywhere. It has been quite the party, and they are now playing We Are the Champions. The party is going to be going on for quite some time here. Some people have said that this is probably their best moment in Denver sports history, and they can't believe that this moment is here. Guys, there are so many smiles here tonight.
Kelly Ranky might be in, probably the second hottest place tonight,
yes,
the NVR Sports Bar. They are rocking there. And boy, what a time of life to, you know, when the Avs won the Cup last year, it was like a practice parade for these Nuggets parade that's going to follow in a couple of days here. But, you know, I think I told you that the last city to do that, go back-to-back, was Boston. The Bruins won the Stanley Cup in 1970, a year after the Celtics had won the 1969 NBA championship. So you're talking about more than 50 years before a town did it again, and Denver's the town.
Denver's the town. And we were so usually tied to, well, thanks to the Avalanche, to hockey, but also football. And that's how people just viewed Denver. And when I saw Peyton Manning in the final seconds
the crowd
of that game,
went nuts when they put him on the big screen.
He was like, you know, like holding his breath and everybody else. And he's been in those moments to imagine what he was thinking too, how it feels.
You know, it's you just look at how this Nuggets franchise has evolved, because it used to be that the Nuggets wouldn't even get into the mainstream of people's mindsets until the Broncos put their footballs away in December or January.
Yeah.
And the Nuggets would then suddenly go on the radar of everyone.
And it's like, oh, yeah, they do play basketball here.
Great,
honestly.
Great fans. But if you go back a little further, you know, the Nuggets had to fight for attention. And now here they are, the centerpiece of Denver's professional sports franchises with a championship and another Denver parade.
Yeah, that's it. Let's go Nuggets right behind us. They're ready.
So we are awaiting some of our other reporters who are mixing and milling with some of the crowd here. We're also going to be hearing the post game and the presentation of the Larry O'Brien Trophy. I mean, there is so much that happens. The NBA sends out a release that has what we do if Game 5 goes Miami's way. Then we get on a plane and we all go to Miami and do this thing again. But if the Nuggets were to win tonight, there's a complete process, and they rehearsed it this afternoon. The whole process of how they're going to present the trophy, where everything will be. It's very much orchestrated. And another interesting thing I thought when I got to see some of the pre-game practicing, the ESPN ABC television crew gathered on the court for what amounts to a team picture.
Oh.
Everyone who worked with them in their broadcast. And the centerpiece of that was Mike Breen, the play-by-play announcer. This was his 100th NBA Finals game.
Oh,
so
I saw that.
Congratulations to him on that, because that's a great run. And I think for many of the people who maybe weren't so thrilled with Jeff Van Gundy or Mark Jackson or some of the other parts of the ESPN ABC stuff, Mike Breen always played it down the middle.
Yeah.
Excellent, excellent broadcaster.
And that's nice
to
see.
Of the all-time greats.
So we know Kelly Ranky will have ringing ears for many hours, but she is there where they're living the dream and singing and everything else at the DNVR. They're still singing, Kelly. Or what are they chanting?
I don't know. They're chanting MVP. Honestly, guys, I've lost my hearing, and I'm not going to have a voice tomorrow. But we are having so much fun here. We were able to talk to some fans right as that game was ending. And again, this is really what people have been saying is the greatest moment in Denver sports history for them. DNVR opened up at